ABC 12's Newsmaker.
There was a time when Flint Community Schools set the standard for excellence in education. People from all over the world came to the district to study its community education model. A model developed in the mid-30s by educator Frank Manley and philanthropist Charles Stewart Mott. At its peak, more than 40,000 students were enrolled in dozens of school buildings, including four high schools. By the turn of the 21st century, the city of Flint was in the grips of a downward spiral. Dealing with the loss of tens of thousands of manufacturing jobs, declining revenues, a dwindling population, and deteriorating neighborhoods, the school district that was once the spark in education had lost its shine. Decades later, new hope is emerging under the leadership of Kevlin Jones, a product of the Flint Community Schools. His vision to re-energize, renovate, and rebuild the district, piece by piece, is coming into focus.
We've renovated four of our buildings, Holmes STEM Elementary, Brownell STEM Academy, Potter Elementary, and Doyle Ryder Elementary.
Flint Schools Superintendent Kevlin Jones joins us for Newsmaker today as we look at the progress, the challenges, and the future of the school district. Our show begins in moments. I hope you can join us.
Focusing on our themes, re-energizing, renovating, rebuilding, and repurposing. We're going to be talking about the visioning of the district, what the board has set out for us to do. So we're excited about the year. It's going to be a fun, safe, educational year for our scholars.
A new school year is in session for Flint Community Schools. Under the leadership of Superintendent Kevlin Jones, the district is in a new era of hope. Enrollment is steady, buildings are being renovated, curriculums reevaluated for maximum learning, all fueling enthusiasm among staff, parents, and students. Welcome to Newsmaker. I'm your host, Dawn Jones. The vision is to re-energize, renovate, rebuild, and repurpose the district. The visionary is Superintendent Kevlin Jones, and he joins us today here on Newsmaker. Thanks so much for joining us,
Superintendent. Glad to be here. Glad to be here.
So let's go back 3 years ago. You become the leader of the Flint Community School District, a district that you were educated in.
Absolutely.
When you got here 3 years ago, at that particular job, coming from a principal at Doyle Ryder.
A principal at Doyle Ryder and then assistant superintendent.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. What was your first priority?
The first priority was to understand what the Board of Education needed from me. That was the first priority, to really dive into where are our issues. Looking at also the bigger picture of the district, what needs to change for the Flint kids? What can we do for families that's going to spark energy in our district to make change? So that's what we focused on. Board, what is it that you want to see? What is it that are, you know, your major concerns for moving Flint forward? And that's what we focused on.
And so you took what they said their concerns were and created this vision for the district?
Well, yeah, you know, when you look at, the board is the what and the administration is the how.
Mm-hmm.
So when you look at how that intertwines, we're working together to do what's best for our scholars. And so once I get the objectives from the board, you know, I go and I sit back and I do my meditation and thinking, look at the data across the district, in all areas of the district, and begin to really pray honestly about where should we take this district and how we're going to get there. And when I say we, I speak of this administration and this team. Mm-hmm. Because I can't do it alone. And so that's how we came up with the vision of the district and decided to move forward full force in that space.
In 3 short years, you've accomplished quite a bit. Last year, we know the district graduated more students than it had in many, many years.
Yes, we did.
Enrollment is steady. If not growing, it's at least steady. You're not losing students. Tell us what other accomplishments in 3 short years that you are touting under your leadership.
We've done a lot. We've done a lot. There's been a lot of work in and out of the district to support Flint kids. We can say that we've implemented a strategic plan from not having a strategic plan in play to the board finally voting in the aspirations of the administration. We did that strategic plan not only with the administration and the Board of Education, but with over 100 stakeholders. And that included teachers, paraprofessionals, principals, central office staff, and also parents and scholars. So we reached out in our community, and we also had community partners supporting that strategic plan. And so now we're in our strategic plan doing the work.
How has being a product of this district shaped your leadership of the district?
So when you think about our vision around re-energizing the pride, which is the first theme of the vision, re-energizing the pride, I think about when I had the opportunity, right, to go to those rivalry games. I had the opportunity to go to those math competitions. I had the opportunity to see Mateen Cleaves or Glenn Rice, right, or others do magnificent things for the city of Flint. And not only that, but I also remember going down to Auto World where the proms were, right, and watching the cars come up, and all of those things energized Flint. When I go to my teacher's classroom, when I was in the sixth grade, I remember going to my teacher's classroom, and we walked into classrooms with 30 kids having a great time learning, spelling bees, right?
Yeah.
All of those type of things happening. Community school directors. When you think about re-energizing the pride, we're talking about what it used to be like, what it is, and what it will be. So we're re-energizing that pride that Flint had when we did have those major jobs here, right? Those Fortune 500 companies here, where everything was booming in our community, Water Street Pavilion, just all the things that we had that our scholars are not experiencing today. And so when I think about re-energizing the pride, I think about they need to know what Flint really is. And if I'm a conduit and my team is a conduit of getting our kids there, then we're going to do that.
Yeah, you brought back so many wonderful memories. Shout out to Otis Spann and his family. Rest in peace, Otis Spann.
Absolutely.
He was my community school.
I worked with him.
Yes, school director. Gave me my only paddling I had in elementary school. But
Mr. Pugh gave me mine. Mr. Pugh.
I adored Mr. Otis Spann. So, you know, though that old guard that was
absolutely
in the community. And let's switch gears and talk a little bit about the vision. You talked about re-energizing the pride, but renovate, rebuild, and repurpose, also a part of that vision and mission.
So the second theme is renovating the plans. And when we talk about renovating the plans, you know, I think about my wife is a lover of HGTV, right? And you look at some of those homes, but you see potential. You see all the potential in those homes. And I'm really speaking of not just staff, but we're looking at our buildings, we're looking at the curriculum, and sometimes you have to renovate because what was is not necessarily what works now. And so putting ourselves in the mindset, in the team, in the mindset to say it may have worked in the 90s or the early 2000s, but it's not working today. So when we talk about renovating the plans, we're not just talking about curriculum, we're not just talking about infrastructure, but we're talking about our way of thinking as well. The plans we're making, the systems that we have in place, the processes, making sure that policy is up to date, and our administrative guidelines, all of those things matter. And getting our team out of the mindset of this is the way we've always done it.
Yeah.
And our board has moved out of that mindset. This administration has moved out of that mindset. And we're moving our employees out of that mindset. And so,
and open to new things ways of doing
absolutely.
Things.
Absolutely. The box has to, we're not getting out of the box. We're eliminating the box, mm-hmm. right? And we're trying to move our adult practice into best practice for our scholars.
Yeah.
So we're renovating the plans. And then when you talk about rebuilding the possibilities, well, that's when we talk about infrastructure as it pertains to building a new high school, as it pertains to renovating buildings, mm-hmm. As it pertains to new curriculum. And so we have all new curriculum across the district. We have all new furniture in all of our classrooms across the district. These things that I'm talking about to you today has not happened in Flint for
decades.
Come on.
Decades.
And so not only renovating four buildings, I'm talking.
And I want you to stop right there because in our next segment, we're going to talk about these renovation plans, and then you can talk about repurpose as well as part of that plan.
So the curriculum. You know, mm-hmm. we decided that our scholars deserve STEM, STEAM, which includes the arts, mm-hmm. thinking about ways that we can upgrade and give them a modern place to learn. So what you're looking at in schools is the same setup that schools have had for years. Mm-hmm. A teacher in front of students that are sitting down in front of a book. We know our kids today are hands-on.
Yeah.
What are we doing about that? So when you talk about rebuilding possibilities, mm-hmm. we're talking about rebuilding the possibilities of learning, yeah. new ways, hands-on activities, and making sure we have modern infrastructure inside the classrooms.
We're going to continue our conversation with Superintendent Kevlin Jones of the Flint Community Schools when Newsmaker returns.
They are excited. There was just one staff member cried. We are worthy of these type of upgrades on the north end of Flint.
We also have ensured new, safe, secured vestibules.
2,700 students walked through the doors of Flint Community Schools for the start of this new school year, and many of those students entering buildings that have been renovated, upgraded, and made over. Superintendent Kevlin Jones is our guest today here on Newsmaker, and in the last segment, we were talking about rebuilding the possibilities, and we're now going to take a more in-depth look into the buildings, the physical buildings, the things that you've done, how you've rebuilt the possibilities of the buildings.
We're so excited to have teachers and staff members that are just in tears about what the Board of Education and this administration have decided to do with the ARPA funds that have been given to the district to support our scholars. We focused our attention at the onset of this administration on rebuilding the possibilities in our buildings and in our infrastructure. Mm-hmm. Four of our schools, Doyle Ryder, Holmes STEM Academy, Bronnell STEM Academy, and Potter Elementary, have received full renovations. We're talking from the roofing, mm-hmm. New roofs, new parking lots, new furniture, new walls, new classroom spaces. We gutted those places out for the most part and just renovated those buildings. And the not only that, but the secure vestibules. Mm-hmm. This is a prototype for what we want all of our schools to look like as it pertains to making sure we have secure entry areas, mm-hmm. where families don't just walk into the building and you can just go into classrooms. No, you have to go through a secure entry area, then into the office. You have to be buzzed into all spaces in the building. And so we heard our families when we had 14 forums. When we asked our families out in the community, not just our families, but the community, mm-hmm. what do you want us to do with this money? What do you want us to do as it pertains to making Flint's future even better? And they spoke up. They spoke about, we want new classrooms. We want new buildings. We want to see even a new high school, and we can get to that.
Yes.
but we went we forged forward into that work, and we did not stop. It was day in and day out. We had support with construction, and we moved those guys, general contractors. We moved mm-hmm. them fast. I got on their nerves. the board was on me to get this done, and we worked hard to get this done.
And we're looking at some of the improvements.
That's Doyle Ryder.
That's Doyle Ryder. Some of the improvements.
We wanted a new concept in Doyle Ryder's, and of course our hydration stations in all of our schools. There's been so much we've done over the last 3 years as it pertains to renovating and rebuilding possibilities. I'm not going to even be able to tell you everything that mm-hmm. we've done. But when you talk about new modern spaces for children, Flint Community Schools has done that.
And they deserve that.
They deserve it. When you look at schools in the area, when you talk about charter schools, and no, not to charters, but you're talking about one building, mm-hmm. right? Every charter school is one district, one building. But when you look at your traditional public school, you're looking at multiple buildings, mm-hmm. one district.
Yeah.
And so for Flint Community Schools to be able to renovate four buildings and add furniture to all buildings and renovations in some of the other buildings in the matter of 2 years, right? For our scholars, that's big work.
Yeah, $100 million project.
$100 million project, yeah. Right? So that's big work. And I don't want it lost on our community that this is something that was easy. This was not easy. It took a lot of work. It took a lot of effort. It took a lot of language to put together mm-hmm. to ensure that we're doing things the right way. And it took all year round construction work. And so we're happy with what has been done. We're not yet finished, mm-hmm. But we are so excited about new gymnasiums and we have a new project going on that's going to hit summer of 25, which is our resource center, The Cube at Brownell Homes.
Mm-hmm.
And that project, along with the Mott Foundation, who sponsored that project, is going to be a groundbreaking project, never been done in the United States of America. So we'll talk about that at another time. Yeah.
Now, before we move to our next segment, we have to take a break here. But before we do that, how important are these upgraded aesthetics? You know, when people think of education, a lot of people don't think that aesthetics are important.
Oh, wow. So,
but how important are these aesthetics to the general learning environment mm-hmm. and to the morale of the staff and the students and the parents
Absolutely.
Who are trusting you with their children?
Mm-hmm. When you walk up on a house and you want to buy a house, the first thing you do is you're looking at it, right? You're not looking at square footage first, you're looking at how it looks. Mm-hmm. And then you're not seeing what's on the inside until you look at what's on the outside. It's the same thing with our families. Parents want to make sure that the school that their children are going to is aesthetically beautiful. Mm-hmm. It looks appealing
Has
to the
curb
eye.
Curb appeal.
That's right. Mm-hmm. And you know, many people will say that it doesn't matter what the outside look like, but it does. It matters how we present ourselves. It matters how we present our buildings. And so we have taken a huge leap forward in making sure that we're modernizing the facades of our buildings, mm-hmm. the signs of our buildings, the landscape and all that. It's all important, and families do look. I look as a parent myself.
And it helps to re-energize the pride.
There it is. You got it.
We're talking to Superintendent Kevlin Jones of the Flint Community Schools, and we will continue our discussion when Newsmaker continues. Welcome back to Newsmaker. We continue our conversation with Superintendent Kevlin Jones of the Flint Community Schools. And in this segment, we're going to talk about repurpose, that part of the plan. We've re-energized the pride and
renovated the plan.
Mm-hmm.
Rebuilding for greater possibilities.
And now it's the repurposing part of the plan. A number of school buildings are vacant because this district was built for 40,000 students many years ago. And we're, you know, at 2,000, mm-hmm. you know, students now. So a lot of repurposing, mm-hmm. you know, has to go into how the district moves forward. So
sure.
Tell us about how you're repurposing the
sure.
district.
Sure. First, you know, the population of Flint is different, mm-hmm. right? So that means that there are less school kids in the city. Mm-hmm. It's about 15,000 school kids in the city, and we serve
roughly now, as of this week, 2,900 of those scholars.
Oh, and almost 3,000.
Yeah, our enrollment is at 2,900, and we're excited about that. So when you talk about repurposing for a brighter future, we're looking into how do we want to look later, right? Mm-hmm. And what do we want to do now to stop the blight that we own? So the board and I went on a journey about doing feasibility studies, and we looked at how much land we have, how long our schools have been closed, what they look like, what have we been doing to keep those schools boarded up. Mm-hmm. And we have decided it's time for us to take action on this. We took action on Washington Elementary School that was in rubble. We took action on McKinley Middle School that had a unit there that was dangerous for our community. We're looking at some other possibilities now of what properties need to be not only secured even better, but what properties that may need to be demoed. It's going to take money. Flint Community Schools doesn't have the money to demo all those buildings, but we're working with community partners. We're working with the state of Michigan on ideas of how we can get monies to flow in for that purpose. But repurpose means that we're trying to turnkey some of our community partners into those buildings that we're not using for education.
And if we could take the next video here, I want to talk about this school in particular because it's my school, Flint Central, in the cultural center.
Yes.
Is there a repurpose plan for this building yet?
Our goal is to build a new high school on that property. We are halfway there as it pertains to what it's going to take financially. We are working with not only legislators and partners, but our board and I. We're constantly working on what we're going to do. We do have some ideas of what it's going to look like. We've had some things drawn up for us, but that is the plan. Central will be a new high school, and we hope to have.
Are
that.
You breaking news on Newsmaker?
Central will be a new high school. It is already in the plans. We're just working towards those plans.
Yeah. Very quickly, I have two questions remaining and little time. I'd like to know about your biggest challenge right now, and then give us a snapshot of what Flint Schools District, Flint Schools, the district looks like in 2030.
Sure. The biggest challenge we're facing right now is we have a teacher shortage, of course. We have some wonderful teachers in our district. We have programs that are allowing, it's called Talent Together, allowing some of our staff that are not certified teachers to become one for free, to go back to college. And it's a nationwide teacher shortage, of course. That is one of our biggest challenges that we have in our district.
Okay, and in 20 seconds or less, what does the Flint Community Schools 2030, what does that look like? In 20 seconds or less.
We absolutely want to double our enrollment. New, brand new high school. We want some energy efficient buses rolling around. We want to be out of deficit completely in 2030. And we want to see all new elementary schools as well in Flint Community Schools.
A bold plan, but achievable?
Absolutely.
And what's it going to take? Community and?
It's going to take the Board of Education, this administration, being consistent with our goals. It's going to take partnerships, and it's going to take the state of Michigan supporting this work monetarily as well.
Kevlin Jones, Superintendent of the Flint Community Schools, thank you for joining us on Newsmaker.
Thank you for having me.